is the good word.
Hey, Jamie, how are you?
Well, doing well, but what I want to know is what is the BizTini of the week?
All right, let's talk about it. Well, I wanted to do a classic cocktail, but my take on it. And I'm doing a Blood and Sand, and that's a cocktail that was back in the 30s. It was made, named after Bruno Valentino's bullfighting movie called Blood and Sand.
Okay.
And it's made with blood orange juice, scotch, fortified wine, and my change on it is I put habanero juice in there.
Okay, yeah. I like that. I love spice, so
right.
you got me.
And you know, scotch, most of the time people just take an ice cube and do their scotch.
Sure.
But we wanted to do something different, and you can have a cocktail with it, because you can drink it in cocktails if you know the right way to do it.
Sure.
Absolutely. All right, let's go for it. So, we're going to take our scotch, which is a American scotch that's made in Washington State.
Okay.
And it's put in oak, American oak barrels. Now they say that Washington State climate is the closest to the highlands that it can get because of all the ocean and things that go at it, the closest to the from Scotland.
Oh, okay.
And it's made with American barley, and it's a single malt. So let's give that a try in there.
Excellent. Okay, very good. Interesting.
All right, so we're putting a shot in there.
Okay.
All right. Then we're going to move on to our Antica. Antica is an Italian vermouth, fortified wine. And it's got heavy in cherry, raisin, mint, vanilla, and it adds a nice little take, smoothing things out with the scotch on there.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. This sounds good so far.
Antica. Now, what my little take is the difference is the Bitterman's habanero bitters is what I use.
Okay.
So I use a little bit of that because you want to have some good flavor at the hot, but you don't want to be overpowered by the hot. Okay, so our last thing we add in is the blood, which would be the blood orange juice. Now you want to use a good blood orange juice. You don't want to use anything out of the can. You get a fresh one or squeeze your own if you're inclined to do that.
So what would you say the difference between like a regular orange and a blood orange, other than the color, obviously?
Color,
but
yes.
Like, yeah, what?
Well, it's interesting. The blood orange is going to be a little sweet, but it's going to be a little bit tangier too. It ups its game in orange juice.
Okay.
And if sometimes
right.
I think orange juice is just kind of like that, you know, this is great. And it helps with the scotch as well. So bring it all together. And now we shake. And I always say shake vigorously.
Okay, I like it.
All right. It's a beautiful drink, and I think all the flavors really come together with it. There we go. And then you wanna top it off with a little bit of orange peel. And when you do this, it's when you get all the juices out, the oils come out when you twist it like
yes.
that.
Okay.
And then you want to put it right here. And there
beautiful.
You go.
Beautiful.
Arena Caliente.
Okay.
Enjoy. Good.
Wow. Man, like that is excellent.
Well, right, well so who
absolutely.
Are you going to talk to today?
Okay. So I'm going to be interviewing a gentleman named, hold on, drum roll, John Lymberopoulos. That took a few
mouthful, but you did it.
But I did it. Yeah, so anyway, this guy is so interesting. He founded a company called Harryson and Peters.
Okay.
All right, and he's going to be telling us a little bit more about that in itself, but it is a high-end men's clothing. So, you know, suits, ties, just really, really fine clothing, which I love. I can't wait to learn more about that. But something else that he also does, which I found just fascinating in this day and age, he has something called the Gentleman Warrior. Okay?
Gentleman Warrior. Okay.
Right. And so what it does is it teaches men about etiquette, manners, and style, which is something we can all really use. You know, I need
to come
bring
back.
It back. And he's bringing it back for the modern man, which I think is just really, really neat. So I'm looking forward to learning more about that.
Absolutely.
And just kind of his take on everything and how he's grown and had to pivot, you know, because a lot of times businesses have to pivot.
Oh,
so I'm really
we all have.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. If you wouldn't mind, make him one as well and meet me over at the table.
I will.
Okay. Thank you, sweetheart.
Always a pleasure.
Absolutely. Take care.
You too.
Hello. Hello and welcome to BizTini. I am your host, Jamie McCarty. So today I'm going to be talking to John Lymberopoulos. This is the founder of Harryson and Peters. Hello, John.
Hey,
and thank
Jamie.
You so much.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here with you. It's
absolutely
wonderful.
Absolutely. Oh, listen, so here's Leanne. She's coming in with our drinks right now.
We even
now.
Get cocktails for this.
Yes, we do.
BizTini.
Welcome to Birdies.
Hi, Leanne. How are you? Thank you.
There you go. A little cocktail I made especially
wow, what
for
is
you.
This?
Well, it's my take on the blood and sand cocktail. It's called Arena Caliente, which means hot sand. Enjoy.
Okay.
Great to see you, Jamie.
Absolutely. Great to see you. Yeah, so you'll really enjoy this. This is fantastic. So I know there's several things that I wanted to talk to you today about, yep. But just to start off real quick, can you tell me a little bit about Harryson and Peters?
Harryson Peters Atelier Clothier is a men's luxury custom clothing company that I founded a couple of years ago. I had had a passion to be in men's fashion for many, many years, and after about 20 some odd years in corporate America, mm-hmm. I finally decided to let my passion become my profession. I'd been in the industry for about the past 12 years, and finally it was time to be able to take what I'd learned in luxury custom clothing and apply that and kind of take it to the next level. So that's when we started Harryson and Peters. We're really focused on quality craftsmanship, elegant designs, and a luxury experience for the gentleman.
All right, very, very good. So let me ask you, was there something, a who or a what, that inspired you to get into this industry?
There was a couple of things.
Okay.
The first was taking that knowledge base that I had for so many years, and I had the pleasure to be able to, great opportunity to work with some really great companies. One was even a fashion house out of Italy that I got to spend some time with as one of their directors.
Nice.
So I really got to see the inner workings of how garments was and the creation of them from a custom standpoint. So that was one of the inspirations. The second inspiration was my two sons, who I actually named the company after, Harryson and Peters. One is Harry and one is Peter. And I wanted to do something that would leave a legacy for them.
Very nice. As
I tell them, I say, boys, you know, you can run and work the business when you grow up and ready to go, or you can sell it when I'm dead. But it's gonna be yours, and it's the legacy that I wanna leave for them. So that was a huge part of the inspiration that I had for Harryson and Peters.
Wonderful. So are they showing that interest? Are they moving in that direction?
Yes. Yeah? One's a sophomore a junior in high school.
Okay.
And the other's a freshman in college. So they're probably the only two guys that I know that both have at least two custom suits each.
Oh, sure.
So they're pretty, pretty lucky fellas. So.
Yeah, I would say so. Okay. So no doubt in business, everybody faces challenges. I mean, there's just no question about it. So what challenges have you faced, and then how did you overcome them?
I think one of the biggest challenges in the luxury market is that it can be a crowded space that's not always populous. And what I mean by that is, to be a luxury company, you have to not only have the goods, but you also have the service that needs to go along with that. For example, you ladies get all kinds of pampering in your life, right?
Yes,
for us guys?
Yes, we do.
We get a shoe shine, we get our hair cut. So an opportunity to get a custom garment, a custom piece, whether it be a shirt or whether it be a suit, is really kind of a fun experience for the guy. And that's where we try to make it very special for them, by giving them an experience that they can then look back on and be like, that was really cool. I got something that fits me great, I had a fun time getting it, and they're a customer for life.
Oh, no, I like that. I absolutely like that. That I can imagine that would keep them there. It's one of the few things where they can find that pampering
exactly.
And feel good about it, too. So with innovation being like a key to business development and even survival, you know, what are some of the ways that you've had to kind of shake things up in your business model in particular?
Well, one of the things that we wanted to do was to take that luxury experience to the next level. And the first part of that, I mean, is really from what we offer. For example, as a custom company, we do three different levels of custom. We do that of custom, right, which the measurements are taken, then the tailor cuts a paper pattern, and from that paper pattern, they chalk the fiber, and
wow.
They start to make the garment.
Okay.
The second level of what we do is called bench made. And if you remember, back in the old times when guys were making these suits in England, they literally worked on these high top benches, okay? But for what it means for us today is, a bench-made suit has more than 220 steps and has over 40 hours of handwork. So this is a very handcrafted garment. And the third level that we do is bespoke, which is the ultimate in that suiting experience. A gentleman comes in, we will literally build that shell on their body as we measure them.
Wow.
The tailor will then craft that canvas to come in for a second fitting. And from there, I use that as kind of my canvas to take measurements and tweak here and there. And then once the final product is delivered, it's 99% spot on.
Wow.
And I mean, that's just a great way. It's just a great experience to see a guy slip that on for the first time when he does a bespoke suit. So
all three. No, it's got to be different. Yeah, I can imagine.
It is different.
Off the hanger is one thing, but when it is tailored for your body specifically, I can speak to it as a woman too. When it's custom tailored, there's just nothing like it in the world.
Two things happen when our first clients get a garment. The first is they put it on and they're just, this is wonderful. I love this, it's great. The second thing that happens is the guy will look, he'll put it, he'll try it on, he'll look at me, he'll go, this is all wrong. This doesn't fit, it's tight, I don't like the way. And so I stop him and I say, you know what, I'll tell you what, I want you to take 2 weeks, I want you to wear the suit, and then after 2 weeks, if you still feel things are tight and uncomfortable, I will absolutely take care of it for you. If I even need to make the garment over again, I will.
Okay.
Now, invariably, within 3 or 4 days, I get a phone call, and he's like, John, this is the best suit ever. My wife loves it, she's giving you compliments. I'm getting compliments at work, this is great. And here's the secret, it's because he's wearing something that fits, right? So many guys go around wearing what I call the pup tent of fashion, right? Because they buy off the rack, and they don't really get that right fit.
Right.
Custom is more expensive, but it also means that it fits well and wears even better. And when you start to understand the value of what you're getting, we only do European cloths, okay? All of our craftsmanship and tailoring is done in North America, okay? So those are some important factors to me as I built that next level of luxury within the marketplace to be able to offer benchmade suits, to be able to offer a true bespoke experience. Only short of that if you were on Seville Row getting the real deal. So it's that next level that we wanted to take things to that has really been a welcome to the marketplace, and we've been very, very lucky.
Oh, that is fantastic. Yeah, I can imagine people getting used to, they're conditioned to think that off the rack, huge, that's the way it's supposed to feel, because that's what they're used to. But that doesn't mean it's right.
Doesn't mean that it's right.
Yeah, absolutely. So here's something that I saw on your site, and I'm very interested, okay? There was something called the Gentleman Warrior. Okay, this seemed really neat to me. So, speaking to manners and etiquette and style for the modern man, tell me a little bit about that.
It's a great concept that I came up with several years ago, and it's continued to kind of evolve itself. It's what every man should know and every woman should expect. Okay. So in this day and age, I think that we have lost that edge, that art of etiquette, manners, and style. Okay. There is part of what we do from the clothing standpoint is image, right?
Mm-hmm,
and
absolutely.
Image matters, right? Right, wrong, or indifferent. You are going to be judged and profiled within the first 30 seconds of either walking into a room or meeting somebody.
It's right? The truth.
No. The Gentleman Warrior concept deals with the second part of image, which is the imago, and that's your image inside. Your self-image and how you project that out to the world, okay? So in that is the skills of things like etiquette, manners, and style. So what we've done is we've created 9 mantras, okay?
Okay.
And I created them as mantras because I didn't want them to be the 10 rules or the 10 ways to become a gentleman warrior, because those mantras will mean a little something different to different guys. And then it's a practice. It is something that you continue to do and that you try to get yourself to do better and better. When it comes to the etiquette, when it comes to the manners, those are some hard and fast things that we can teach guys on what to do. And we can also teach the ladies on what to do as well.
Sure, absolutely.
This all started as a result of a theory I have that men have become a bunch of emasculated wussies. And I was one several years ago, so I can stand up there and say
and
the
say
same
it.
Thing.
Yeah,
okay?
Right.
So what I wanted to do is create this program, The Gentleman Warrior, so that guys could get back to being men, could get back to being gentlemen, to know the things to do when it comes to dating, when it comes to dinner parties, when it comes to traveling, business meetings, all those other things. So we talk about all those things, and the sessions that I do teach those things to companies, to organizations, so that when their folks are out there doing it, they're doing it better, right? It all comes down to a matter of respect. One of my favorite sayings, and it's really the training program or philosophy for the Ritz-Carlton hotels, is ladies and gentlemen serving ladies and gentlemen. Love that.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
So that's basically the crux of what we're talking about here. So the Gentleman Warrior is really that concept, that brand, to embrace that with guys, to become a little bit better than they were the day before.
Okay.
And I think we can all do that.
Oh, absolutely, and you're never too old to do so.
Not at all. I still learn things to this day, right?
Don't we all? Yeah. No, absolutely. So if somebody wanted, would they go to call you? Would they go to your site to learn that?
You can go to our site. Yeah, there's a Gentleman Warrior page on there, and it shares some more of that information.
Oh, that is so interesting.
And then if your group is interested in doing a program, I've done full-day programs, I've done two-hour programs. I've done dinner programs at universities to take students through a 5-course meal. And during each course, we talk about different things that they're going through and what they're experiencing, how to enter the room, how to sit down, when to leave, how to work your silverware from the outside out, how to teach them to eat continental style versus American style, which a lot of these things a lot of people don't know.
Right? Okay. Yes.
Because we've learned so much of this by looking at the table next to us. And so that's all right. So we're giving it some bit of formality around it and a little bit more education so people can say, you know what, I feel comfortable doing this. And when you have that confidence on the inside of your image, it comes out on the outside as well.
I can imagine. It definitely is going to have to, you're going to feel more confident. You're going to feel more comfortable, like you said, instead of going into a room and you're like, I don't know what to do, and I'm afraid I'm going to look goofy, or I'm going to, you know what I'm saying? So
right.
I think that is.
So we're trying to help people learn so they can prevent the preventable errors.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
And in this day and age, it matters.
It does. Okay? No, it really, really
Competition
does.
For jobs are as high as they've ever been. There is, the social element of this thing. So somebody that can really fit into that, and I'm not saying that you have to be the hoity-toity,
right,
but having that good general knowledge is what's important, especially for gentlemen and for the ladies. You gotta let us be gentlemen, as I tell them.
Right? I absolutely agree.
So at the end of the day,
you,
it's what every man should know and what every lady should expect.
Oh, I love that. I absolutely love that. And I have one final question for you.
Yes.
Okay. Shaken or stirred?
Ah. Somebody who is a fan of the Renaissance of things in life, right? I'd definitely say shaken.
Okay, I share it.
You always got to push it a little bit, right?
Yes,
gotta push
absolutely.
It a little bit.
No, I love that. I love that.
I love having that classic style with a little bit of an edgy spunk.
Just a little bit. No, I absolutely love
Cheers
that.
Cheers to that. Cheers
yes,
to that, right?
Thank you. Yes, absolutely.
Oh, that's delicious.
She is so good. She is so good. Well, listen, thank you so much for joining us today and
my
sharing
honor.
Your
thank
story.
Thank you for letting me have you be here.
Absolutely. And I want to thank you, all of you, for joining us today on BizTini. And I hope to see you next week, actually, where we have another story and have another BizTini.